Today in this video, we are going to talk about PM100 equipment from the SATEC company. PM180 equipment, it is a microprocessor-based multifunctional device which can be used for the power quality analyzing, power metering, emergency recorder, data lodger, and a programmable controller focused on substation of automation. The PM180 provides a three-phase electrical measurement in power distribution systems, external event monitoring, control of external equipment operation via relay contacts, and also the fast and the long-term recording of measured values, and the recording of the short circuit currents up to the 100 ampere network harmonic analysis and the curve from distortion recording. What consists of PM180? The equipment has the 6 module slots and the 3 fixed slots for the factory installed modules. First one, it is the CPU and the current transformer modules, and the 3 slots for the general purpose hot swap modules, optional discrete and the analog I/O measurement and the communication modules, and the redundant power supply module. The optional modules can be installed in any available slot. How to turn it on? The PM180 has the 2 independent power supplies. First one, it is the main. The second one is a backup. The main power supply has the power supply of AC voltage. It is from 50 to 980 volts. The second, it is the DC voltage. It's 90 to 290 volts. And the connection to the main power supply, we need to the AC voltage phase L to the L plus terminal, and the neutral to the N minus terminal block of the voltage. About the DC voltage, we need to connect the plus to the L plus, and the minus of this cable to the N minus terminal block of the voltage, and connect the redundant power supply. Communication with the device. PM180 can be established independently and simultaneously through any communication port using the PAS software support provided with the instrument or using the user software. All communication ports are slave ports and has factory preset parameters such as baud rate, data format, and the communication protocol, which can be easily changed as needed. The first one, it is a USB port. It is a standard USB communication is 10 times faster than the serial communication, can provide at maximum transfer rate. A second one, it is a Ethernet port. It is a standard. The 100 base T Ethernet port provides a direct connection between the PM180 and the LAN via TCP or IP protocols. The TCP servers can be support up to 5 simultaneous connection with Modbus or TCP DNP 3.0 or TCP and IEC 60875 and 104 client application. About the measurings, the AC inputs and the AC and the DC input terminals connect the internal circuit of the product through the input transformers, which isolates the product from the external circuit. About the voltage inputs, the instrument has three transformer isolated and one height impedance voltage inputs. It is 690 watts and RMC direct interface voltage with 190% of overload, and the voltage channels are designated as from the V1, V2, V3 and the V4. To ensure the correct voltage measurement in your instrument, you must specify the nominal secondary voltage and the ratio of the primary to secondary voltage, VT voltage transformation ratio, of the external voltage transformers. About the current inputs, the instrument is equipped with the current input, the transformer with the rated current of 5 ampere or 1 ampere. All models are supplied with the 4 100 ampere extended current range transformer as a standard. To extend the dynamic range of the current inputs, the current measurements are made in two measurement range independently of the model. One is standard current range up to 20 amperes to 10 amperes for precise measurement of the power. Energy and the harmonics of the other is the extended current range up to 100 ampere used for measuring and recording short circuit currents. This device can also be equipped with four additional current inputs using the DFR module to measure independent short circuit currents. The display of the PM180 equipment, we can see the buttons of this PM180 equipment, and if you want to connect to the PAS program by the computer or laptop, we need this IP address and the default gateway. By using the select button, we see these options. We need to connect with the options, enter, and it goes up to the net. You see net, and need to click on the enter, and we can see the IP address, and the second one, it's the default gateway. And if you want to for example change the IP address or default gateway, you need to click the escape and go to the changings, enter the password of the all of the equipments from the SATEC. It's always 9. Enter, and goes up to the net. Enter, and we can change the number of the IP address or default gateway. Connecting by the IP address to the PAS application software, we need to click to the folder and go to the power quality log and click to the open. After we open this folder, we get information about some events and the fault category and so on. For example, we get information about the event, the date and time, when did it happen and how much time, and about the event and the buy. How much events happened, for example 202, 203 and so on. And we get information about the fault category, voltage dip, impulsive voltage and so on. After that, we get information about the phase, fault magnitude, and about the duration, how much time does it happen. For example, we can click to the event waveform log 7, and we get waveform log 7 about this event. In this waveform, we can zoom in horizontally, and you can see the changing in this waveform, and the red line, do you see this red line? It is about the event, and where did this event happened. We can undo the zoom in, and also we get some very useful functions in the PAS program. It is delta. For example, we can click to every point, any point of this, and we get the time duration. For example, it's 27.172 milliseconds, and the PAS program, it's very good when we need very accurate information about to the milliseconds of this event. And we also can go to the another waveform. We can also zoom in and see the time duration by the delta. You see it is 21 milliseconds. And we can get some information about this waveform. Let's move on to the another. For example, we can get information to another event, waveform log 7, and
by this waveform we can also go to the delta and get information about changing in this waveform. As you can see, this waveform is constant, but this waveform we can see the changings, and we can also find out the time duration of this waveform changings, and we can get information about the frequency. Do you see in this red line, it's something happened, and by this event it's we can see the the changing in the waveform. Also we can get information about another waveforms, for example it's harmonics. In the harmonics we can get information about also the channels, for example about voltage 1, 3, and about the power quality and so on. We can see the detailed information, and also this in detailed information about harmonics, about the kilovolts and so on. After the getting information about the waveform, we can move on to the next part in the and also we can get information about the reports. For example, we can get automatic reports. We need to click on the compliance statistics, click on the folder, and we get detailed information about the compliance report. For example, the measured result, it's 0 volts or 5 volts, and the normative value also we can see minus 10 or 10. And we get information about the measurement uncertainty, estimation, permissible value, and we get a detailed automatic report about frequency variation, about the voltage imbalance, and also about, as I said before, about the harmonics in the detailed. And we get some information about the interharmonic components, and about the flickers and the voltage dips and so on. It's very useful when we need to make automatic reports in the manufacturing. In the future videos, we'll tell you more about the power quality indicators and which this standard is based on.